No one has called me, but I've gotten so many comments and DMs that I was naked, I'm doing the wrong thing. Some people that are not even Muslim said I'm spoiling the Miss Nigeria culture. Honestly, I don't reply them. I don't say anything. I just move on. The crown is already on my head, so there's nothing I can do. My name is Shatu Garko, and I'm be the 44th Miss Nigeria. When they announced my name as the 44th Miss Nigeria, it shocked me. I was surprised, I was overwhelmed, I was super excited. And then I started crying, like tears of joy. Everyone started shouting and clapping. For the past 4 or 5 days, it feels emotional. It feels really different, but I don't think anything changed. When I was growing up, I always wanted to be a queen because I see many people on TV, Miss Nigeria, Miss this. But I always wanted to be Miss Nigeria, even though I didn't know how or I didn't know anything about it, but I just wanted the title Miss Nigeria. And you know, when we're kids, we have toys like crowns, this fairy stuff, whatever. And so I used to wear my crown and I'd be like, oh, I'm a queen and everything. And then I have a sister that calls me princess, so that made me feel like, okay, you're a princess. And she still calls me princess. So now I guess she has to call me a queen. The things where I win as the 44th Miss Nigeria now, 10 million naira, a big free house for 1 year, ambassadorship deals, and a car. I think the most challenging part of growing up was secondary school. Being a Muslim and going to a missionary, Catholic missionary school wasn't so easy. The criticisms and, well, it was actually easy to adapt to the environment and everything because we're not forced to do anything that was out of our religion. Honestly, Nigerians like judging people. Many people said the president paid for me to get the crown. Many people said my state governor paid for me to get crowned. Some people said my parents paid Miss Nigeria team to get crowned, but that's nothing, it's not true. Like, waiting I won't do with my crown for the next 1 year now to eliminate menstrual poverty and educate young girls and women on menstrual hygiene.